Okay, so I'm just gonna grab our last texture that we made in high poly sculpt, which is this kick plate for the door, and I'm just gonna grab it and throw it over to our door spot here in the bottom right-hand corner, and just place this into place, scaling it to fit it to the right size. Okay, so there's our reference of our kick plate here, and I have the normal map around here somewhere. There it is. So I'm just going to bring it up and line it up here. And then it's a little bit off scale, so I'm just going to throw it on a different mode for difference and line it up to scale it down. Just so the texture lines up right. I'm gonna flip back to our normal, and I'm gonna bring this down, and just move these rivets manually, just so it fits right. And then I have to move a couple more of these rivets down to extend it, and that way it just fits on our original texture sheet better. And I'm just going to cover up this line here, this extra line in here, and finish the bottom off. And then merge it and rename it. And so now we can move on to our next pieces. I did a few of these pieces before I started recording, but I'm going to go into the process of actually showing the rest of the pieces. They're pretty much like the same concept, so I'm just going to start, continue on. Okay, I'm just gonna show you a good example of depth, the kind of depth we can achieve with using Endu. So first of all, we have this pattern here that we would like to turn into a normal, and we have this cut-in section here, this post pole here. Let's see here. So, make a new layer, and first I'm going to go for this texture here. What I want to do on this one is something new that I haven't done yet in this tutorial is using the pen tool to then make a shape and then make the normal out of it. So, if you're unfamiliar with the pen tool, it's over here. It'll create a vector line that will allow you to create a selection of it and then make the normal out of it. So what I'm doing is clicking here, clicked here, and then if you hit Alt click on the point, it will give you a point that's not has attachments to the other point. See, if I keep going with this point here, it's now going to curve the wrong way. So basically what alt-clicking on the point does is it there's no history on the previous point. So you can move it however you want. If I was to do this point without clicking the alt here, it would give me a really strange result because of the pole, the pull tabs here, which you can use to adjust the point, but we don't want that, so I'm gonna hit delete. And if you alt click on a point too, also you can hit delete and just delete that point. So I'm gonna click here, I'm gonna click here, left mouse button click, and then alt click here, and then click here. And a lot of times Illustrator uses a pen tool for its vector graphics, but it's also in Photoshop. But if you're unfamiliar with how to use the pen tool, I'll kind of go over some simple tricks and tips here. This point here isn't really needed because when you're using the pen tool, the least amount of points that you make, the better it is, because the more points you make, the more problems you can run into. So to create this line here, I would probably click right here and then just pull on it. But see, if you pull on it first and then try to make this point, it's going to give you that bad thing again. So if you click Alt, it'll get rid of that. Or if you didn't want to click Alt there, let's say, you know, further on down the line that we're going to run into that, you can click here and don't stretch the point all the way to where where you want it at, but just click right here, and this is more of a click on our future points. So if you click right here and then click again, you're not going to get a huge distortion of your point, and then you can continue on. And then later on, if you want to go back to this point, you can click Control on it, and then move the handlebars. So that's kind of the best way of using it, is to create your points and then go back and modify them later. Just by clicking on Control and then checking on the point, and then these two pull bars will let you do the rest. So that's kind of see when I were getting that thing there. So hit Alt, and that'll get rid of the previous history of that last point. And okay, so I'm just gonna fast forward through this part here. These are all kind of repetitive actions, so I'm gonna still show them in the fast forwarding part of it, but there's no need to go into it second by second. So now we're down to the bottom, so I'm going to go back up to the top and hit Shift and then click right here, and that makes a straight line that we don't have to do the other end now. We don't have to do the right side. So now that we got our points done here, I'm just going to go back in and zoom in a little bit more and see if we can go back and modify any of these more of these points to make this selection just a little bit better. I think I did a pretty good job at the this will now be my second time doing it, because I already did it previously in this tutorial to kind of see what we need to do. But so this looks pretty good. This is a little bit off right here, so I'm just going to move that. You can also select on the handlebars to move stuff. This point here is not really necessary. Oop. If you end up deleting a whole section or the whole thing, just Control Z it. Good. Check this point here, and I think that's about good. Okay, so now if we go over to pass here, we have a new path. We're going to rename it just B, just to have a different name from the first one, which was the one previous site I did while making this tutorial the first time. So now all we have to do is control click on this box here, and that gives us our selection. Make a new layer, and then Alt backspace will fill in our selection. I'm going to copy this layer, go up to Edit, and transform, flip horizontally, and then move this over so it fits there. And then I'm going to merge all three of these layers. I think the one was blank, but if we control click here, we can see that up here is good, but down here is some missing information, so I'm just going to paint that in black. Okay, I'm just going to hit Alt Backspace to make sure we have everything in that make sure it's a solid black, and then you can click on the selection to normal box here. Wait for this to get done. And there we go. We don't need the black background one, but I'm just going to call this, I'm going to save it as black selection. Okay, so now we're going to kind of change this to show a little bit more control. That looks pretty good. Not much really I want to do much besides maybe soften it a little bit. Okay, so now we have that, but we're missing all these little details in here. So you could go in there and you can do a bunch of pen tool and make all these little selections, these feathers and these leaves. But what I'm going to do actually is go back to our original texture or the picture and make a selection. And I'm just going to copy this here of this design. Hit Control C, Control J. It makes a new layer of that selection. And then I'm going to go in and make a normal of the actual bitmap picture. And what we're going to do is we're going to use both of these to match up and show a combination of both of them. So this is what it looks like in the bitmap. So we're kind of, it's kind of messed up right now. So if we go to chiseled, no, we want to keep it on smooth. Size, move that down. The bevel, I think emboss works pretty good. Contrast, bring that down. Depth, bring it down. Softness, I'm going to bring it up. And already we're getting a pretty good result here. We want that up. And I think I used half round before. Or was it cone? No, that's not it. Valley. And you can experiment with these different options here, but I think I used, you just use the regular one, just the linear. Okay, so that's there. So now I'm going to take the pen tool information and put it underneath this bitmap. And then I'm going to turn this off and turn my normal map off. And so far we have that. And then I'm going to go to a blend and go to soft light and then turn this back on to see our result. This is just the layer that Endu creates for you to show a normal map. So that looks alright, but I think I used overlay. And see, now that's without our hand drawn, and that's with the hand drawn. This is with both. So we kind of get a better result from it than just doing one way or the other. It's a combination of both. So now I'm going to select these two layers and make a new group of them and name this detail section. And then turn this off, which is the original normal creation from Endu. And then I'm going to make the selection of here. Make sure we get everything in there. These leaves right here need to be in there. And then hit create add layer mask. That's going to cut out just that one portion for us. Okay, so now I'm going to do this background here with this indent. That's going to be underneath, so I'm going to create a new layer underneath. And get my rectangle, but I'm going to do rounded rectangle. And make the radius about 12, and then drag select this into here. And actually that needs to be just a hair bigger, but we can go ahead and make this first. Just click on this selection, vector selection to normal. And it's gonna create that for us. Size is a bit big, and I think we want it chiseled. Depth is pretty good, soften it just a little bit. And then I'll make it just slightly bigger so that, I think I looked at the wrong part before. See, there's this part, then there's one more part right on top, which could be a regular without. Now the smaller one here is going to be a different type of bump. It's a little bit less depth, a little bit less height, and it's perfectly square, so the corners. So I'm going to hit this, and then I'm going to make it slightly smaller than the previous one we just did. The size break down, and I think that's probably good right there. If we turn that on, now we can see the background. And then I'm going to do two more of this section. First, I'm just going to create a background. So where this black is here, we need something to cover that. So it's just going to be a regular normal. I'm going to hit the button here to create it, and then I'm going to bring the depth all the way down. Just make it a flat plane. That way we just have something in the background, so it's not going to show anything. But okay, and then we're going to create this little lip here, and that's going to be going down in the opposite direction. So we'll hit the create vector to normal again. Wait for it. And the first thing I want to do is change the slant. Instead of up, go to down. And make it a little bit bigger. And make the chiseled. Looks like we're a little bit over to the left. So I'm going to make it a little bit deeper to the left. The right. We could use emboss, I guess. No, we'll probably just go better with inner. And the curve, we want to make this cone, or just kind of mess around with them. I went on a sec. I think I used that one before. That one looks pretty good. And so that's pretty good for that. So now what we're gonna do is make the border here, which is going to be, I'll just draw it out here. I'll point out the spots that we're going to use. It's going to be this from here to here to here, and this is kind of like the outer box, and then also here. So let's do that right now. And for this, I'm going to use just the regular marquee tool, just because I can add more of a selection to it. I can keep on adding pieces without having to use the just the vector box. Because the problem with that is you'll get edges that you don't really want. With this option, it'll all just be one object. Now if it'll ever load, I might want to do a save right now, because sometimes Endu has a tendency to crash. Let's see here if it's going to... You just gotta wait it out sometimes. I'll pause the video and until this is ready. Turns out actually when you're doing this at 4K and you have a lot of normals and you have a lot of layers, it takes up a lot of memory. But I want to keep all those layers in case I have to go back and change something later, given that if I compress them down to one layer, I won't be able to edit them later. It it's a destructive workflow. So,
Okay, so I'm just gonna fast forward through this part here. These are all kind of repetitive actions, so I'm gonna still show them in the fast forwarding part of it, but there's no need to go into it second by second.
And so now we can move on to our next pieces. I did a few of these pieces before I started recording, but I'm gonna go into the process of actually showing the rest of the pieces. They're pretty much like the same concept, so I'm just gonna continue on our door here, the top right corner.
And if we just go to our layers here and just kind of cleaning these up, moving them back into place. Now we'll open up our undo and click on startup undo for our normals, and we'll get this box here. And then I'm just going to draw a shape that's in vector form, and then click on this button here that makes it into a normal. And then I'm going to adjust the size of the corners. And I'm going to draw another box in here to fill up the rest of the background of the door, and then bring down the size and then the bevelness. And draw this window in here, and then click on the convert tool and make it negative slant or downwards, and then change the settings to match an inset window. You just gotta kind of play around with these settings and figure out which ones are good for like a bevel like inset window. And I'm gonna make the hinge and move the size down a little bit, and then make it chiseled and make the softness go down a little bit, because it's gonna be a little bit more of a metal part. And I'm just going to make it round these edges for the part of the door hinge, so it's a little bit round. I'm just going to copy it over for our other two hinges to make three of them, and it's going to sit right on that door border. And then I'm going to make this like wood part here and just extend it all the way to the ground and hit the convert tool so it makes it into normal. And I'll make the slant go up, make our softness, and then make it a little bit more size. And then I'm going to throw it underneath the other layers where it should be, so it's behind everything else. And then we're going to make our window here. It's going to be converted to this normal part, and then slant the negative, and then move the size down, make it chiseled. That'll make like an indent, like an inset window. And then all we need to do now is the molding, or the in between everything from the door part. So I'll just convert that to a normal, and then bring our size down or up a little bit, and move it onto the top layer. We're putting it behind the hinges in the door. It'll show up a little bit better. And it's going to adjust this window here a little bit, and we should be good from now on this part. So what I'm going to do here is copy our my previous map that I did before I started the tutorial of the block walls, and I just copied the normals from that file to this file. And then we're going to go back to the original file here. And now we have our same size blocks that we can use. So I'm just going to take them and I try to make these blocks here, and so I'm just going to rotate them and then move them kind of into place, and make sure that they're all together and figure out what we need exactly. So probably don't need all of them. So I'm gonna go ahead and just kind of see which ones we don't need, and then delete them. These ones that are off, we'll just delete. Basically, all we need is like two rows, and I just want to make sure that it lines up here. So I'm gonna turn on my grid, and I have it on the whole layer on difference, so I can see and through the so I can see through the object. Basically, all we need is like two rows, and I just want to make sure that it lines up here. And we'll just scale these accordingly to fit this. So I'm just gonna scale this end, and then this end here. And I'm just going to drag this down to about there and then scale it, and then do the same thing for this this other piece here. Scale it up and kind of move it in between where these parts would be. And we'll delete all the edges out later that are you know, overlapping the space. So it's going pretty well here. Pretty simple stuff. And right here, I'm just going to make a little like a border bevel. And now we can take all these this group here and add a mask to it. And so that looks pretty good. So I'm just going to kind of fast forward to this part, and it's kind of just a repetitive action. I'm just lining them up like I did before. That's it for this video. I'll see you in the next one.